this particular topic, I would like to show you how a username and password can be verified. First, I'll show you a common mistake which people do, and then we will improve upon it and then see how it is best done. So what I'll do now is, first thing, I'll go to SQL Server and I'll create a new table here. Let us say a login table in which I'll have PK user ID. Now this is the standard notation which our software development follows. In our organization, we start all primary keys with PK. That's how we follow, just as a notation. Then I will have username, which has varchar field. I'll have password, this which is also varchar field, and probably many more other columns can be present. But for demo, these three are fine. Save it with user profile. Make PK user ID as primary key. I want username, password, both to be not null. Then also we would like to have here PK user ID as identity column. Remember, identity column is possible only if it is of type integer. Any other type, it cannot be identity column. Now save this. Now saving is not permitted. The changes you have made require following tables to be dropped and recreated. You have either made changes to the table that can't be recreated, or enable the option prevent saving changes that require table to be recreated. So basically, there is a problem now in the configuration of Management Studio. It will not allow you to make changes like this. So what we have to do is, in Table Designer, rather in Options, there is Designer, this checkbox you'll have to uncheck it. Go to Tools, Options, Designer, and uncheck this. Prevent saving changes that require table recreation. Uncheck that. Click on OK. And same is the setting even if you are using Visual Studio. Go to Tools, Options, Designer, Table and Database Designer, and uncheck this. Click on OK. Now save it. It will drop and recreate a table without any problem. Now that we have a table, refresh here, it should come. Right click, edit top 200 rows. I would like to insert some data now. Say user 1, password 1, user 2, password 2, user 3, password 3. Just dummy data I have inserted. Now for this we would like to code now in front end. So go to Studio, we'll add a new project, a new form. Let's call it as login form. And on this login form, I'll have a facility for username and password. Username, password. Just align them properly. And of course, a button for logging in. Give proper names quickly. This is txt username. This is txt password. Now we have to write code in login click. So first on top, we will write using system.data.sqlclient. And in login click, we'll have to verify if the username and password is valid or invalid. So start with creating a connection object. Set the connection string. Then we need to write the SQL statement which is going to verify if the username and password is valid or not. Now what is going to be our SQL statement? The common statement which is written is something like this. Select, something like people would write count of star, from user profile where username is equal to, I'll put a string.format. In single quote, 0, and password is equal to, in single quote, 1, where username is so and so and password is so and so, comma txt username dot text, comma txt password dot text. And to confirm, we generally put a message box that everything is fine. Now to execute this query, I need a command. So command is equal to new SQL command with SQL statement and the connection. Now how will you execute this? This is going to return to us only one value. So the best way to execute is integer count is equal to convert.toIn32 and give here command.execute scalar. Execute case scalar return type is object, and that's what we are going to get here. And what generally we do is if count is equal to 0, we would say message box invalid username or password. And if count is not equal to 0, we generally say message box something like verified and found correct. And we would take further action appropriate. So this seems to be the proper solution. Let us verify if this is working or not. Save it. First, before I execute, I go to program.cs and I'll make this login form as the startup. Run. Give username, user 1, password, login. Select count of star where username is equal to username and password is equal to password. Correct. Execute scalar requires open connection. Sorry, I did a small mistake. I did not open the connection. I did not close the connection. So here we would say connection.open. And once executed, we would say connection.close. So give again username, password, verified and found correct. Good. Give invalid password, invalid username and password. Very good. Now what is the problem? Is there anything wrong in this code? As such, we see it is working fantastic. What could be wrong here? Nothing seems to be wrong. No, there is a problem. Now what we are doing here is, when we are comparing username and password, SQL Server does case insensitive comparison. So if I run this application and give here user 1 and let us say password, I give it as even uppercase, which is actually not in my case. I've given pass 1. It will still say it is valid username and password, which is wrong. That means the basic problem is SQL Server is doing case insensitive comparison of these strings. Now when SQL Server does case insensitive comparison of this string, for username there is no problem, okay, but password case insensitive is not correct. And that is what is a blunder in this particular select statement. So how do we overcome this? There are different ways of doing it. One is, we convert username and password both to var binary and then compare it. This value and this value, both you convert to var binary, using var binary feature of SQL Server. Instead, if you want to do it in front end, what I suggest is replace this count and fetch password. I would rather fetch even pk user id and password I'll fetch from user profile where username is so and so, and I'll not give password here. I'll not give password. I'll only give username. So for a given username, we'll fetch the password and PKID. Now, what is the change we'll have to make? Now we cannot use execute scalar because we are getting two columns. Now, when you are getting two columns, we would write here SQL data reader is equal to command dot execute reader. So this execute reader is going to fetch me now either one row or zero rows. If the username matches, it will get me a row. If the username does not match, it does not get me a row. So what we will further do now to check whether the row has come or not, in data reader there is a method has rows. Has rows will be true if there are rows. So if there are no rows, obviously username and password is invalid. Two, if rows are there and what is important, the password which we got, that is dr of password, which I convert to string and compare it with the password entered in text box. If it has rows and if the password provided in the text box matches to the password fetched in the front end. Now front end equal to does case sensitive comparison. In such case, I will display the message so and so, else I will display this message. Cut from here and paste it here. And of course, when we are done, we will close the connection. So small change I have made. Now let's verify first and I'll explain once again. I now give username, same, password which I give first, let me try invalid. It should say, see, no password condition now. So will I get a record actually? Attempt to read data when data is not present. Has rows has become true. Yeah. Problem is, has rows has got us true. But did we go to the first record? We haven't. That is the problem. See, has rows will only tell us rows are there. But unless I go to the first record using dr.read, it has no meaning. So what we should do now? Instead of using has rows, we'll say dr.read. So dr.read does what? It takes me to the first record. If there is a record, it returns true. And then we are getting data at that particular record. Try. User 1. Verified and found correct. Something is wrong. Logic is wrong. Put a breakpoint. Run. User 1. Invalid. So dr.read should give me true because username is there. So it gave me true. Good. dr.password is pass 1. If is equal to something. No, it is not equal. So this becomes false. When it is false, it should take me to the reverse. I'm sorry. It's correct only. Just that this should go here and this should go here. Condition is correct. So run again. All cut copy paste problems. User 1. Invalid. Invalid username and password. Type uppercase. Correct password but uppercase. It will still say invalid username and password. Now type the correct password case. And it should give me valid username and password. So this has now made password as case sensitive. So very important. Don't write select star or select count of star from and then compare both username and password in the where condition. Because that will do case insensitive comparison. Ideally, give the username put to backend, get the password in front end, and password you verify with the password entered in the text box, provided of course there is a record. Chances of username itself is incorrect. Try that case also. Username itself is incorrect, so it should immediately tell you invalid username or password. Why? Because read returns false in this case. When it returns false, there is no data. It doesn't even go here to the next second part. From here only, it will go to else part and execute invalid username and password. So small task, but very, very important learning. The learning is simple. SQL Server always does case insensitive comparison of strings when you are using it, especially in where clause. If you do not want case insensitive comparison, there are two options. One, get the data in the front end and do front end comparison, or else use convert both the columns to where binary in backend using SQL Server facility and let SQL Server do binary comparison rather than string based comparison. That's all in this. Thank you.